So I'm Patrick Viana. I'm art historian, and I worked for many years in the Museum of Industry in Ghent. Later on, I worked in the Museum of Industry and Social History in Brussels. And in the 90s and later on, I was teaching at the University Antwerp in the Department Heritage Studies and in the High School of Ghent in the School of Art. I was a co-founder and president of the Foundation for Industrial and Scientific Heritage in Flanders. And for many years, and still I am member of TIKI. I was also board member during 9 years, but now I only, as a retired man, member of this important heritage association. Tonight, I will speak about the coal processing plant in Beringen. We try with a lot of people to preserve integrally this outstanding and impressive industrial monument. Good evening, everybody. Thank you for joining this small conference. Thank you for the organizers, CIA. And I thank also Bart van Akker, who is next to me for technical advice and help. Thank you, Bart, one of the key figures in the organization of this project. Photographers and experts engaged in the preservation campaign of the coal processing plant in Beringen in Belgium. You see in the picture at the right side the immensity, the impressive dimension of this listed monument. Although it is endangered with partially demolition. That's the topic of this small conference, how to preserve such a complex and impressive building. Where is Beringen? Well, Beringen is in the eastern part of Flanders. That's the northeastern part of Belgium. As you can see on the map, Belgium has only 150 miles of wideness and 100 miles from north to south. It's a micro country, but a very important country. The first one in Europe to have been industrialized with a tremendous industrial heritage. The oldest mines, especially coal mines, are of course not in Flanders, but in Wallonia, and that since the Middle Ages, pre-industrial times. And because of the extensive Walloon steel industry, coal was also needed, more coal, and that's the reason why in Limburg, coal was digged in the beginning of the 20th century in difficult circumstances and transformed the landscape and the society in that remote region. We had had seven coal mines closed one by one from the 60s of last century until 1992. That's 8 years after the last mine of Walloon, the Walloon region closed the doors. Important is the date of 1994, where about 50 mining buildings and structures became historical monuments, including the mine of Beringen in its entirety, so also the coal processing plant. During the last 20 years, a lot of things happened in Beringen with the renovation of parts of the mine infrastructure for different topics. For example, a diving center was installed in a former thickener and other facilities. You see also in the down, in the picture down, the impressive coal processing plant. two parts, section 1, 2, and 4, are renovated now for different uses, offices, hotels, and services. The two older parts, 1 and 3, on the structures are threatened with demolition and replacement by new buildings. It is important to conserve the complete coal processing plan for the future. In these schemes, you will see at the left side the complete structure, and at the right side what's happened if the plans are becoming reality. The same can be seen on this view with 2 and 4 conserved and renovated, and the other parts in bad estate, in structural good estate, but much of the structures suffers from decay. Why conserve the complete coal processing plant? First of all, it is a listed monument. If you know that in Belgium, we have only 100 listed industrial monuments and 12,000 churches and castles and so on, and windmills, you will know that this is a shame to break down such a structure after removing this structure from the list of conserved and protected monuments. The second reason why to conserve it is this: the last and only structure of this type in Flanders, the last one. And we have three smaller examples of coal processing plants in the south of the country, in the near Liège, Blangy, Peronne-les-Bains, the blue star on the map, and a remnant, a ruin in Doul, the mine of Sauvartin. But these are smaller, more recent, and also partly conserved at the interior site. This is Blangy-Trembleur. This is Doul. Really a ruin middle in the middle of the woods. And this is finally Peronne-les-Bains, who is listed and conserved from the outside, but the inside lost 90% of his equipment. That in contrast with Beringen, where most the main interior equipment survived. As can be seen on these archive pictures, and here on recent pictures realized by my colleague Bart van Akker and myself. The third argument and reason to conserve the complete structure, it is the most impressive building on site, and destroying parts is affecting the integrity of the whole mining site. The parts who are now under renovation, these are very recently taken photos, you can see that the technical equipment is completely lost. So it is important to conserve the whole thing. Why not renovate the entire monument? An important fact is that other parts of the mine are reused very successfully. As you can see here, the thickener of coal dust, now used as a diving tank with an excellent restaurant. Here you see other parts of the mine. The reception building is a tourist office. The social building is a mining museum, number two. Number three, the electric power station is now full of climbing walls. As a sports center, you have bicycle repair in workshops of the mine. So it is a small, relatively small effort to complete the job and also renovate the complete coal processing plant. Finally, co-processing plant, you have different materials who are sorted, who are cleaned. Nothing is lost. And such an installation can be considered as a precursor of contemporary sorting installations of sustainable ways of production. What is the actuality? That's the key point of the lecture. The owner and the promoter, BeMine, encouraged 2 years ago the public authorities in Flanders to nullify the protected status of the main part of the historical monument. But what they didn't expect is the reaction of 1,300 citizens and experts protesting against the demolition. Very recently, after these protests, the attitude of the owner and real estate developer seems to change. Let's hope in favor of an integral conservation. Besides of juridical actions by different associations with who did successfully fought a demolition permit granted by the provincial government, other initiatives are being undertaken. That is one of the things now we are doing. It's a photo exhibition and a publication with the title Triage, Sorting, the co-processing plant of Beringen, a monument of the future. The organizers are ETWI. So Peter, this is a colleague of you, Yuri Januarius, who is working very hard in the organization of this project. Further, we have Het Vervolg, and finally myself. The premiere of this exhibition is foreseen in just 1 month. It's to say the 18th of June, and will travel around after closure in Ghent. We selected 10 photographers. So it was possible to select hundreds of them, but due to the limited space, we selected 10 people from different countries. All these photographers are fully on the side of those who want to preserve the Beringen coal washing plant. And it is interesting that they show photos of the plant in dialogue with other processing plants in and outside Europe. Not only coal processing plants, but also lead and silver processing plants are shown in the exhibition. So this exhibition is in three languages, Dutch, French, and English, and will be a traveling exhibition. So you are free to invite us to lend this exhibition in the United States. Why not? The photographers are really exceptional, each in his or her field. I cannot explain every photographer. I show you here a book, Entre la Tierra y el Aire, from my colleague in Mexico. And then we have the publication. Because an exhibition is lasting no long, a publication is important. We have a lot of experts, not only pictures of photos of the participants, but also background texts. One of these texts is of an engineer, Lambin, who explained the procedure to split and to sort coal dust and coal and shale sandstone and the evolution of the technology through the ages. It's a very important part of the book. It is the hidden part of the coal mine. It is the dirty part of the coal mine, but was really necessary and crucial in the processing. Next chapters go about the renovation and the possibilities to save these mines. And we have Massimo Prete with
listening. Sure, wait on repairing that.
Who is listening now? And he wrote a very groundbreaking article, The Dinosaurs of Industrial Heritage. And he gives concrete examples explaining also the levels of their preservation in the range of possibilities. So I go very quickly over the different levels of conservation. He explains you can have a documentary conservation with photos and a 3D numerical surveys of a monument and then break it down. So this is, of course, the lower level of conservation. For example, in Savannes in France, this is, it's a pity, but the monument is under destruction now. You can also keep the ruinous state, the archaeological conservation in the landscape, as we can see here in Sardinia, in Italy. You can conserve coal processing plants as open air monuments with visits who are possible by following trails. You can conserve, this is a real high degree of conservation, a coal processing plant as a museum with partly conservation of the technical infrastructure, as we can see here in the Ruhr Museum in Essen. And finally, you have the integral conservation with no museological alterations and the full conservation. So this is an article that is very fundamental in our view. Further on, Paul Bautzen speaks about the historical and technical development of the bearing and coal washing plant and the history after closure with recent and actual perspectives. I'm very happy that Leo van Broek, the Flemish government architect, follows our opinion in the complete conservation of the coal processing plant. Then we have some studies. I can't go in detail, but they are very interesting to compare what is done. We have to learn from other people. We have the cases of Blangy. It's an archive center now, it's offices, exhibition center, but a part, the upper stores are conserved and can be visited with a guide. The coal processing plant of Peyron-les-Bains is in good state, but the inside is lost. This structure was built with the aid of American funds, the Marshall Funds, in 1954 and was only in use during 15 years. Here you see a very interesting example. It's a park with water. Water is the most important element. And you see the parts going through the structures, but the shape is conserved. Also sculptures of the difficult times of the 30s in Germany. An excellent example of a museum in coal washing plant is the Ruhr Museum in Essen, closed during COVID, like all the others. Genuine combination of conservation and documentation with place also for other exhibits. And finally, we have the example of Mexico, Pachuca Real del Monte in the state of Hidalgo, where there is an eco museum, while other parts of the mine are still in function, like the Beneficio de Loreto. So to conclude, I look to my watch, I have 1 minute. Good practice examples show that coal processing plant as Beringen can be conserved, can be reused with a minimum of efforts. You can say it's a lot of money. Do you know that 20 millions of euro is the price of 5 kilometers of highway? So everything is relative. Our project wishes to sensibilize a wide audience, not only experts, and of course also to convince the deciders to conserve the complete processing plant. So I thank you for your attention, and please give us additional information about historical coal processing plants in the United States. We have very, very few information about similar conservation problems in the States. So thank you and good evening, everybody.